As Cathaoirle or Mayor of Donegal County Council, it gives me great pleasure to speak to our diaspora in Bonnie, Scotland. It is no secret the global pandemic has impacted all of us as individuals, as families, as businesses and communities. If there is one positive I take from this experience, it is the resilience demonstrated by the people to help and support others. When the Christmas lights were turned on at Aras an Uachtaráin in Dublin last week, there was a special installation for the Irish diaspora. The centrepiece by President Michael D. Higgins was a river of light pouring right across the Aras grounds and out to all of the people for the diaspora, and particularly for all those who will not make it home this year, and those who cannot be with their loved ones at Christmas. This year has been very, very difficult for many. So I want to take this opportunity to wish all of our diaspora a very happy, holy and peaceful Christmas, and also a very happy and peaceful New Year. And I look forward to hearing from you in 2021. Thank you.
The echoes from the hills of Donegal are a constant reminder of home to us here in Scotland. The links between Scotland and Ireland are old and new. They are broad and deep, and nowhere are they felt more strongly than to and from Donegal. Our connections of family, of language, music, sport, business, sustain relationships between people and places. This year, we've all been stopped in our tracks. So used to easy movement back and forth, our expectations and our connections have been challenged, and we have suffered sadness and loss. Let's look forward to working and playing together again next year, to trade missions and music festivals, to football matches and picnics with cousins on Donegal's white sandy beaches. Nollig hona sa vóilte díobh go léir.
Hi there, I'm Claire. I'm a member of the band The Frail Sisters, along with my two older sisters, Anna and Sheila. We were born and brought up in Glasgow, but our family ties to Donegal are really strong. We were kind of brought up travelling between Glasgow and Donegal. We would go over to Donegal as much as possible to see our family, to play music, or at one time renovating the house in Donegal. So we were over and back a lot. We'd leave school on the Friday afternoon and we'd spend the weekend in Donegal, and that was happening quite a bit. So we were over and back and over and back. So we learned a lot of our music there and picked up a few songs as well. Our grandmother and that side of the family would have been very musical, and everyone has a tune or a song. So we're keeping that up. We're actually going to sing a song for you now that we learned from Granny. She learned it when she was a wee girl at school in Munalik. It's called A Star Agra. It's a fun wee song, and it's in Irish, so we hope you enjoy.
A star,
a chunk of tuna, one, two.
do a star star, on a chuck a tune, I wanna do a star star, on a star star, a chuck a tune, star star, on a chuck a tune, I wanna do.
It's lovely here. Peaceful. Serene. Rugged and wild. And so many things in between. So where is here? It's County Donegal. But 400 million years ago, here was over there. And where is that? Scotland, of course. Because 400 million years ago, a collision between the American and Eurasian plates caused Ireland's and Scotland's oldest fold mountains to form. The seafloor was buckled up to form the sedimentary rock of the Caledonian Fold Mountains, and from there our connections have grown. Donegal and Scottish people's lives have been intertwined for centuries. Strong cultural and familial bonds exist between many of our people. In Roman times, Irish marauders frequently raided the western coast of Scotland, resulting in the Gaelic language being established and dominating the tribal lands of Scotland for many centuries. The Scottish people were also established in Ireland, mostly in Ulster, and particularly in Donegal. In the 9th century, the Vikings began their raids and established colonies, particularly in the Hebrides and along the northwestern coasts of Scotland. These Norse settlers intermarried with the Gaelic-speaking natives and adopted the language. The resulting mixed population became known as the Gaelgal, which literally means the foreigners who speak Gaelic. The Gaelgal were famous as fierce and brave warriors, and they hired themselves out as mercenaries. In Ireland, they became known as the Galaglas, meaning young foreign warrior. Their historic footprint can still be found to this day. The Gaelic name for the town of Milford in County Donegal is Ballia na Galagla, or Town of the Galaglas. Donegal translates as Fort of the Foreigner. Nestled in an inlet of Sheephaven Bay in County Donegal, skirting the wild waters of the Atlantic, stands Doe Castle, the medieval stronghold of the McSweeneys, a Galaglas clan. Doe Castle, or Caislín na Dua, was a historical stronghold of Clan Sivna, with architectural parallels to the Scottish Tower House. Built in the early 15th century, is one of the best fortalices in the northwest of Ireland. From medieval times to the modern day, the commonality between Donegal and Scotland covers a rich and shared history of sports, literature, poetry, song, engineering, and the seasonal migration of labourers between the two regions. Celtic Football Club was founded in 1887 with the purpose of alleviating poverty in the immigrant Irish population in the east end of Glasgow. Hibernian Football Club, or Hibs, was founded in 1875 by members of Edinburgh's Irish community and named after the Roman word for Ireland. In the 19th and 20th centuries, thousands of Donegal people moved to Scotland for full-time and seasonal work, most taking the boat from Derry to Glasgow. While many got work as housemaids or working in the steelworks, the experience of those in tunnelling and the seasonal fishing and harvesting are most celebrated. Seasonal migrant workers travelled from Donegal to ports in Scotland and England as gutters in the herring industry. Men and women as young as 14 were given their first taste of freedom as they followed the migratory route of the herring from Shetland down the east coast, gutting and packing these highly prized fish by the barrelful. It definitely wasn't glamorous and the work demanded grit and sheer endurance, but the life of a gutter lass offered independence and opportunity to women who were integral to the success of the herring fishing industry. In 1955, a group of Donegal men made history, breaking a world record, a record that still stands today, by tunnelling through 557 feet of rock in 7 days while building the St Fillian section of the Bread Albion hydro scheme in Perthshire. The workers, known as the Tunnel Tigers, travelled from Donegal for seasonal work digging tunnels. They earned the name Tunnel Tigers because they were so driven in their work, digging through the hardest rock using only hand drills and blasting tools. Many of the tigers died while working in the tunnels. Others suffered life-changing injuries and illnesses related to unhealthy working conditions. In 2019, a memorial was unveiled in Dunlow, County Donegal, to honour the Donegal immigrant workers who died digging tunnels in Scotland. Every year at the end of May, and again in September, a small army of Donegal workers travel to Scotland to take in the early and main potato crop. They were known as the tattyhokers. Often they would travel over in squads of 30, some extended family groups, usually from very small communities, and often accompanied by a senior woman who served as their cook. They included men, women and children, some as young as 12. Many people from Donegal were able to support themselves and their families for the entire year by spending the summer and autumn months picking potatoes in Scotland. However, poor wages and work conditions meant it came at a price. Theirs is a legacy of hard work and determination, and their spirit continues to inspire our people to this day. The ties built by immigrant workers, full-time and seasonal, continue to bind. That was Donegal then. This is Donegal now.
It's a wonderful place to live. It's a beautiful place.
It's very easy to do business here.
We're kind of straddling the two worlds between North America and Europe.
We're very well catered in terms of connectivity.
It's a combination of having a high-end career and a fantastic work-life balance.
We have the quality here, we have the skill base here.
People are keen to get work. Graduates are incredibly well qualified.
I was excited to be able to work with a different culture, work within a different country. It's been phenomenal.
If you're looking for a place that is well outside the norm, this really does kind of fit that bill. You can't go any further west from where we are without getting your feet wet. We see a lot of people here coming to visit the brewery from France and from Germany, and for them, Donegal really is a place of pristine beauty. We're an island, but we have access to the European market of 500 million people. We're on the periphery, but we're still not that far away from, you know, the ports that we need to export our product out of here.
There's a history and a provision of good, talented candidates coming through from the different universities, from the Institute of Technology here in Letterkenny as well. The location here that we have allows people to live locally, grow and develop and stay with the company as well. So we actually see that as a huge advantage.
We don't need to be in London or Dublin. Basically, we can run our company from here. Cost of living is a lot lower. Accommodation, rent, food, entertainment, travel, all of those things end up really having a very practical effect in people's day-to-day lives. A good, simple life, work hard, have a good time, go out runs at the weekend, taking the kids to the beach, even though it might be raining, right? But we can go and get fresh air, and that's really important.
From an employee standpoint and a labor resource, you're connected. I can go to London and come back in a day.
A great thing about the location of the northwest of Ireland is the real strong network connectivity that's available. And 25% of our organisation work from home on a permanent basis. Your commute time to work can be anything from 2 minutes to 20 minutes. You can nip home for lunch.
It's definitely doesn't lack whatever you're looking for. You'll find it here.
We would have a community of surfers that live in the coast of Donegal and go surfing in the evening and do software development during the day.
The investment that we have made here has paid back fivefold to us.
If we did it, other companies can do it. And there's a great energy and enthusiasm here for good things to happen.
The people here in the northwest of Ireland are progressive, they're problem solvers, they're dynamic, they're future oriented, they want to grow, and above all, they love having a good time.
We're certainly not limited by our location. The limit really depends on your own imagination.
As we say goodbye to 2020, we do so honouring the time-old traditions that celebrate our kinship. First footing, or the first foot in the house after midnight on New Year's Eve, is still common across Ireland and Scotland. To ensure good luck for the house, the first foot should be a dark-haired male, and he should bring with him symbolic gifts. In Ireland, the traditional gift of coal is presented, and in Scotland it is traditional to bring with you a gift of shortbread and a wee dram of whisky. To acknowledge this tradition, as we don't have a coal mine, we've asked Castlegrove Country House to share their shortbread recipe with us.
Hi, it's Irene here from Castlegrove Country House Hotel. We're a family-run four-star country house on the shores of Loch Swilly, just outside Letterkenny in County Donegal. On New Year's Eve, it's customary to bring a gift when visiting your loved one, and we thought shortbread is a delicious gift to bring as we offer it to our guests on arrival with hot tea. Here is Peter, our head chef, and he's going to show you how to make shortbread, and then we'll have a little taste of it.
Hello everyone, so as Ari said, we're going to make a little bit of shortbread. So our recipe for the shortbread is 4 ounces of butter, 4 ounces of flour, 2 ounces of icing sugar, and 2 ounces of corn flour. So it's a one mix. So you have softened butter, flour, icing sugar, and then corn flour. So ideally you mix this up. Now if you have a mixer in the house, it might be best to put it into the mixer. You mix it by hand. It takes a bit of time. So you just mix it until it blends into one. To save a bit of time, I've made a bit of pastry here, shortbread pastry. So what I'll do, I'll just show you, you can roll it out. So just take a small piece of that. We have a little star here, we're gonna cut them in stars because Christmas. So here we go. So you can roll it to as thin or as thick as you want. Don't go too thin because it'll just crack and break. So that's a sort of a medium thickness there. All you do is just get any kind of cutter at all, but if you can get a wee star cutter or a wee Christmas tree cutter, we just cut them out. It's easy to manipulate and to play around with the pastry. It does dry up after a while, so a couple of mixes, as you see, and a wee side. Once I do that, so we have this. So if I do this again, and you can re-roll it. But as you do that, the pastry becomes a little bit shorter as you do it. So try not to handle it too much, and you can continue cutting. So there we have our star shortbread. So what you do is you put that into the oven at 130 for 20 minutes, approximately. All depends what kind of oven you have. If it's a fan-assisted oven, it's around about 20 minutes. If it's just a flat oven, as I call it, where it's no fan, it could take a little longer, maybe 22 minutes, 23 minutes. So here is the finished product. A lovely piece of shortbread.
Now, Peter, I've been a very good girl this year, so do I get to try some?
Well, hold on, we say, okay, well, we'll let you have one.
Lovely.
There you go. There you are.
Mmm, delicious.
So we'll just let you see the little shortbreads.
So there we have it.
Well, thank you. Good Merry Christmas to everybody.
Yes, Merry Christmas.
And we'll see you all in 2021.
2021.
Our search for a dram of whiskey to complement the shortbread brings us to West Donegal to Sleeve League Distillers. Founded by two scatterlings, James and Myra Doherty, who returned home to reclaim the distilling heritage of Donegal. Earlier this year, in the shadow of the imposing mountains of Sleeve League, a double distilled smoky spirit made from Irish peated malt was filled into a first fill bourbon oak cask by Sleeve League Distillers. It is the first time since the closure of Burt Distillery in 1841 that legal whisky distillation took place in Donegal.
Hi, I'm James Doherty, and with my wife Moira, we're reclaiming the distilling heritage of Donegal. And I've built the first legal distillery in the county for over 175 years. Why? I guess it's in the DNA. I'm the grandson of not one, but two illicit poaching men. Our passion is less clandestine. We want to create quality Irish spirits. I've spent 20 years building international spirits for others, so we have the drive and the skills to create world-class spirit brands here in Donegal. Not just the home of my parents, but also home to a rich, almost lost distilling heritage. Donegal has always been inspirational for us. It's beautiful, it's exhilarating. It's elemental even. And all our spirits deliver this through their taste, design, and the Donegal provenance. These drinks really could only come from here. I suppose we want to make Sleeve League to Irish spirits what Islay is to Scotch. This is where it started for us.
No, you've got to move. It might be where it ends too.
This is where it started for us. And now we're reclaiming the distilling heritage of Donegal.
From one Donegal spirit to another, St. Columbkill, also known as St. Columba, is one of Ireland's patron saints, a distinction that he shares with St. Patrick and St. Bridget. St. Columbkill was born in Garton, County Donegal, around December 7th, 521 AD. There are many sites associated with his life, and many more that are dedicated to him. In 545 AD, St. Columbkill founded his first monastery in Derry. St. Columbkill and 12 monks sailed from Derry to the island of Iona in Scotland in 563 AD. He died on Iona on June 9th, 597 AD, and his feast day is commemorated on that date every year. The 7th of December marks the birth 1500 years ago of St. Columbkill. The saint and his rich legacy have shaped the language, culture and history of Ireland and Scotland. Columbkill founded the abbey on the island of Iona, which became a dominant religious and political institution in the region for centuries. The year-long celebration of his birth will last from the 7th of December 2020 to the 7th of December 2021. The friendships and partnerships developed over the year will hopefully continue to grow as a positive legacy of this celebration for our diaspora. We have missed you this year and look forward to welcoming you all to Donegal when the time is right. Unlike Columbkill, when you make that return journey to Donegal, you will be able to walk and explore the great outdoors that await you. We will end tonight with messages from our diaspora and a beautiful piece of music from the Scottish band Scary Vore with their rendition of Home to Donegal. Please connect with the Donegal Diaspora Project. Find us on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, or connect through the website.
Hello from Dunloe. Wishing the McDyers, the Mooneys, and the Kennedys.
And the Dohertys and the McCall connections. A very happy and peaceful Christmas.
Hopefully we get to see you all in 2021.
Bye!
Hi everyone, it's Craig Gordon here. You're probably wondering what I'm doing on this and what my connection to Donegal could be, but actually my great-grandmother is a lady called Mary Ward. She lived in Roisin, a little croft house there. My granddad also went to school at Burton Port, and my dad spent almost every summer holiday there playing football with Packy at KG Strand, and he's got a lot of great memories and great stories from his time over there. And I also managed to visit. My family had a holiday out there at the end of the 90s, and we had a great week out there. So That's my connection. I'd like to wish everybody a happy new year, and hopefully I get back to visit the area again soon.
Happy new year from Malik.
Agus buianava ur.
Happy new year to all our family and friends in Fulcaraghan, County Donegal.
Wishing you all a healthy and happy new year 2021.
Happy new year from Motherwell.
Fantastic.
Hi everybody over in Glasgow. I'd like to say a big hello to my two granddads, Grandad John and Grandpa Will. I'd also like to say a big hi to the McCann's family, the Marshalls and the Boyles. Hope to see you all soon in 2021. Love you loads.
Hi there, I'm Stephen Gallagher, professional golfer. And what a lot you might not know is that my family name is from Donegal. My grandfather, my great-grandfather, Brian, came over here to Scotland, and that's why we changed from GHER to CHER. And ever since then, I've had an affinity with the place, and I was fortunate enough to play there at Ballyliffin a couple of years ago, and I fell in love with it, and I just can't wait to get back. It's been a terrible year this year, so hopefully next year we're all back to normal. I'd just like to wish you a Merry Christmas, and God bless.
Bon.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all our family and friends in Mallorty.
Merry Christmas!
From our hearts to yours, wishing all our Donegal diaspora a very happy, safe and joyous Christmas. Hope to see you all again in 2021.
Wishing Jim, Susan and all the Browns a very happy Christmas and looking forward to seeing you all in Donegal in 2021.
Hi, it's Lorraine McIntosh.
And it's Ricky Ross here from Deacon Blue.
And we just want to wish all our family and friends in Donegal, especially in Gador, a very happy Christmas and a happy new year.
Yeah, have a great Christmas when it comes, and also a great new year.
Nollag Hanadiv.
To all our family and friends in Donegal.
Especially the Rosses.
Still up for 2021, and we can't wait to come over and see you when we can.
Happy New Year! Donegal!
Paddy Bonner here. I just want to say a big hello to all of you. I know it's been a really, really difficult period for all of us, but I do feel the day is coming that we'll be able to put out the big handshake, have the hug, and celebrate again together. In the meantime, during this period, it's nice to have a different way of connecting and also celebrating this unique bond that we have between Donegal and Scotland. So please stay safe, and a very, very happy new year to all of you.
Hello, we are Daniel and Martin Gillespie from the band Scarivore. We're based in Glasgow, Scotland. We're raised on the island of Tyree, the most westerly island of the Inner Hebrides of Scotland. Our connection is through our father, who was raised in Gwydor and Donegal. And found out more about our connections there over the years, and somewhere we've visited a few times, but somewhere we need to visit more often, and we look forward to doing so in the future.
And here's a wee piece of music. One of the very first songs we performed as a band is a song called Home to Donegal. So please enjoy this piece of music, and also if you want to check out more of our music, you can at scarivore.com, and we'll also be doing a New Year's Day live stream, which you can find a link to from the website. Enjoy!
Have a great Christmas. Cheers!
Thank you.
of London, not far behind. The thoughts of home life occur. My Donegal.